insulting. Try harder.
Okay, come on. Why aren't you working? Come on. Settings. Graphics controls.
Who are you working for?
Hello everybody, this is Landedkiller here. We're trying to get this, the luck to work on Black Ops 4. This game is often very finicky. Because I'm playing with an Xbox One controller, it doesn't want to respond unless I'm inside the match itself, which is ridiculous.
First, I must find a power switch!
Alright, let's see. We don't need to K over shouting my ass every time. Alright, we're just... turn these down to about half. Then hopefully that'll solve the issue with a lot of this. I am sorry if we're kind of backtracking a little bit. But this is Black Ops 1. For the first time in like forever, don't expect me to play Call of the Dead or Ascension because those crash the game. Anything else, I should be able to play just fine. Yes, I kind of turn things down that we can kind of hear me, and the zombie sounds aren't overshadowing my voice. It's been a while since we've gotten a zombies video out on the main channel. I do apologize for that. I've just been, like I said in the prior video, dealing with a lot, but we're slowly trying to get things back on track here. It just takes time sometimes, you know, when you're in the middle of transitional phases to just really get things honed in correctly. We're also in the midst of redesigning a couple of logos, so things may look different. Maybe not when this is uploaded. I don't think they will. If I don't like the logo redesigns, we will stick with the original stuff that I had made myself. So we'll see how things are going. I'm not going to sit there and redo animations right now. I feel like I don't have it right now to redo animations, so we're going to keep our classic animations for now. Maybe at some point in the future we'll change them over to the new stuff. I don't know yet. But I think leaving the animations alone is probably for the best, as I want people to be able to recognize that it's Landedkiller Zombies and not have it be some weird other funky nonsense, you know? It's like, come on. I know that the animations look basic, you know, and some people may not like them, but sometimes simplicity isn't half bad, you know, sometimes. I hate to mess around with one of my favorite weapons, and that's the double barrel shotgun in this, so I'm excited about that. I think, like, one of my biggest things that I always enjoyed doing was, you know, playing Call of the Ascension, but because those maps crashed the game, I can't really do anything on those maps right now with this game, but if the game stays stable enough, I might consider doing some campaign content for the FPS channel. And FPS and zombies are remaining separate from each other for obvious reasons. Each one's a different focus area. Technically, you could probably say, oh, zombies should fall under FPS, yada yada. And I'm like, no. The zombies channel is meant to cover like more horror games, more games out there that are more supernatural, paranormal. Versus FPS is meant to cover the grounded stuff, pretty much. Oh my gosh. Got my side. You gotta be kidding me. Look at me being all rusty and stuff. Let's pull this out. I'm not gonna take any chance with these zombies. Time for some double barrel shotgun action. I like this gun because it's simple and easy enough to use. You just point and blast. That's it. complicated like the other stuff. Let's get the time again while I'm at it. No, not wanting to go. That's alright. I just feel like I've had a revelation tonight. Like, I've really just solved a big issue that I've had to deal with for a long time. But, yeah, the channels are gonna go strong. We're gonna figure this out one step at a time, and I'm excited to see what the future holds, to be honest. I think that the audience that can grow potentially huge with the channels, but it's going to take time to obviously get there, you know, with everything kind of in flux at the moment. If Black Ops 1 stays stable enough, we're going to try to do campaign-style videos on it. Put them on FPS. There's a reason why I started with Black Ops 2 versus Black Ops 1. Because Black Ops 2 is stable versus Black Ops is not. And I know the real hardcore Call of Duty enthusiasts will say, why didn't you just start with World at War? Because you never had issues with World at War. And I was like, I really just have an issue with one of the missions on World at War where I just can't get past it no matter what I try to do. It's this one where you're trying to blow up some bunker or something. Every time I try to do it, I always just can't do it. It just doesn't want to work because it's too sensitive or something. I don't know. Are we going to sit here and do anything funky, weird, any FNAF content coming soon, Landedkiller? Not yet. We're going to take some time first to just get stuff going regularly for the zombies. And once we've gotten things going, I'll try to do some FNAF content again on the channel or something else. Problem with security breach, as I've alluded to a few times now, is that I keep getting stuck on this mission where I'm supposed to basically do Chica's elimination mission, if you want to call it that, and I keep getting stuck on that mission, so I don't know how to finish it. You know, it's crazy. But, I will try to figure that out here in the near future and see if I can get it to work. Because when I go back, I want to be able to produce a steady amount of content. I want to just get stuck again and then I don't upload for a while, because that would be really unfair to you guys. Guys and gals, you know, and in between.
I am ready to unleash my inner warrior! You dare touch me!
I don't really think that we're going to be hitting 1,000 subs on this channel for some time, but maybe in the future we will. As after racing, after it goes racing, Landedkiller show, and then this one for amount of watch hours, pretty much. Well, maybe in the future this channel will just have a bunch of subscribers on it and stuff. It's going to take time, and I'd be a little premature to guess that we get there right now. My biggest thing right now is just going to be trying to get content out there. Not having stuff go nutsies again where we don't have content for a while. I'm pretty good about keeping content going on the main channel. Like, when I haven't put out a video, I've tried to live stream just to keep things kind of steady. God, it got me again. Just shows you how rusty I am. It's been a good minute since we've actually been on Black Ops 1 or played zombies, just because, like I alluded to before, everything's kind of in flux. Oh boy, I'm gonna have to survive when I get to that quick revive. You're not making it easy for me. Part of what I enjoy doing is just getting content out for you guys that you all can enjoy. Guys and gals and everything in between is saying a lot. You know, it's just crazy. Life is crazy. You just don't know what the hell you're going to have to deal with on a daily basis. It's nice when things can finally just settle down for a minute. Finally just relax. Oofed. They got me again. Survive, but hey, I'm trying.
Leave a decent place.
Yeah, I'm really leave this place indeed. Annihilation. The beauty of annihilation. Yeah, that's. I still got that stuck in my head after all these years. Hell. I have to see how good this goes. Right now, using this. Gun might be able to hold him back a little bit. French gun.
You are a waste. By my warrior's hand, you die. See the error of your ways. We linger, incomplete.
If I can hold him back, I'm gonna try.
Your suffering is at an end. The spirits of my ancestors are with me.
I'm gonna give me some decent. Come on.
With this weapon, I cannot be defeated.
Are you kidding me? Come on. Give me something. All right, I can work with these. If I'm just careful enough, I can.
They continue, even as stumps. Advance and fall.
We'll see what happens here. Got me. Happens. A bit tired out, to be frank, but yeah, life happens wherever you are. Well, just glad to be making content again after so long. That's all that matters to me. Alright. Let's see, should I do one more of something? Let's see here, zombies, solo. Like I said, we can't do Call of the Day because it's going to crash. Let's go to Derees and see how long I last. I can't even, yeah. Let's go for it.
No power! Just like home!
Alright, we're just gonna see how long I can survive on Derees. Oof, Black Ops 1 version. You see this map often appears a couple of times. You'll notice that certain symbols don't appear on later games for obvious reasons. different times, different standards, that sort of a thing. So I know some people are offended by that. I totally understand. But history is history. You can't just say it didn't happen, because things happen all the time. Oftentimes, history is written by the victors, and the loser side gets completely erased. That's unfortunate about history. The more frustrating aspects of history, to be honest, because the way that history should be told is that both sides should always be told in history. Because you don't truly have the truth unless you have both sides. That's why I like it when history textbooks kind of have, like, when you talk about, like, Wounded Knee, for instance, you know, they have the Indian side and they have the U.S. government side. Of course, there's a certain slant, of course, to be pro-government, obvious reasons, you know. They kind of fund the textbooks, yada yada, you know. Sometimes they try to not talk about Wounded Knee, some of them, certain states. But Wounded Knee itself is important for many reasons. It was the forced march of Native Americans. Their land got taken away from them by the U.S. government. A lot of crud. Many Native American families suffered at Wounded Knee. Of course, for all, some of us are familiar with the story of Sitting Bull, how he was a leader of his people, and slowly over time, you know, he lost more and more land, drifted to Canada, had to come back. Charles Eastwood, I believe his name is, tries to restore some of the honor, kind of runs into roadblocks, nothing really gets resolved until many years later. And now, things still not resolved and all that. I think it's important that people, again, understand both sides to history so that they know the full truth, you know, about what happened. That's the important thing, because if you don't understand the full truth of what happened in history, then you're bound to make false judgments, again, because you only know one side of history. It's important to understand both sides. Just because you get rid of statues and monuments doesn't mean that some people won't remember the history of what happened, you know? It's crazy. But history should be represented in a full picture view, with there being multiple opinions presented, and not just one. So I hope that these days that history books are being written a lot better than what they were being written back when I was growing up. But again, history, important. You gotta have both sides. Obvious reasons, we're always drawing the whole picture. Like, take any he said, she said, story or whatever, and completely cut one perspective out, like the guys and the girls, and you don't have the full picture. Unfortunately. You can only surmise what happened, but if you take time to understand both sides, then you get the whole picture. That's the point. But yeah, life is crazy. People want different things. They don't communicate sometimes, and that leads to a whole host of issues. Any kind of relationship, you gotta have communication. Without it, you're really just gonna be stuck dead in the water, you know? That's part of the battle. You gotta have to have open communication on everything. It's important.
Yield to the might of Red Army.
I try to do the best I can with that. It's just crazy.
It's the kill.
I'm ready to kick wrinkly ass.
Yeah, you can't really predict human behavior pretty much. It's impossible with some aspects, because you don't understand the full picture. Some behavior can be predicted, of course, but other behavior cannot. Because you got to understand the past, understand a person's past, and that's one way to get some gauge of it. But then people act in different ways, and you're just unexpected to that. You know, that's kind of the thing about life. You got to understand perspective. I think there's value in understanding where another person's coming from, is what I'm saying. But if you don't understand where they're coming from, you're going to run into roadblocks and issues. You're going to be like, oh, they meant this, or oh, they meant that, and it's not the case always. You know? I can claim to know this and that, but unless I've been through this and that, I can't truly understand the situation. And that's kind of where I'm at. Alright, where the hell is it? There we go, there's one of my favorite weapons.
Believe me, I know.
We're just going to try to go wall guns with this playthrough. Just to make things a little bit more interesting. Because the easy thing would be to sit there and open up the box and get the Wonder Waff or something else. Just going to try to stick to the maps guns and see what we can get with this. We're going to even make this a little harder and open this up.
There's a big cable running back to the mainframe.
I don't even know where Quick Revive is on this thing.
You fall like drunkards on my holes. Try eating through your neck hole.
Oh, it's over here. I forgot.
Do I really want to help anyone else? You do not beat me! This is a happy massacre!
Alright, let's move. Try to move around, get over here, and get this quickly. Switch to this. Okay, we got an opening, we're just gonna go for it.
They're dropping like flies!
Okay, we gotta link up the mainframe.
Time to take
this one's usually the harder one to do, so I'm doing this one first. See, we still got a door in the way. Just gotta get the harder one out of the way first.
Feel my blade! You'll die quickly and in large numbers!
Good time to go grab the other one quickly. Do this quick though, because this doesn't last for that long. Like I was saying, not gonna last forever. Gotta get moving.
You would press one button and it would work.
What the hell? I'm noticing random glitches when I'm trying this. I'm getting caught, like the dogs are getting caught. I am so screwed if I don't move. Okay, that is just useless on so many levels. Whatever. That's why I don't typically go after two of them in one round. It's part of the reasons I've dug it out when doing this. Like I said, I'm just half kind of tired when I'm recording this, so. Yeah.
Do I really want to help anyone else?
I don't really feel like leaving channels of content for a long time either. You know, it's just not me.
I'll drink to that. Hell, I'll drink to anything.
Of course you will, Nikolai. Of course you will. And I always believe in drinking in moderation, not overdoing it. Everybody has different limits. When I say limits, I don't mean drink to get drunk. I mean drink to get a little buzzed or something. Leave it at that. I think getting a little buzz is okay, but going beyond that, just getting drunk, that's just stupid. So many levels. Causes problems and everything. That's actually useful.
I got the hammer. Go find me a sickle.
A sickle? That's not in this map. That's an ascension. The hell I'm gonna be able to hold him up for this, but I'm try, I guess. I'm crazy. Oh, will it come for me? Here they come. Let's just get up here. Oh, you will come. I don't want to be a whole month. I'll try. Here they come. So, oh, silly. Is that even worth me doing that? What double points is going to help me from these swarmed zombies? Trying to stay alive indeed. Oh, they got me. Oh, well, that's fine. Getting two maps from Black Ops 1, that's good enough for one gameplay. Right. But that, you know, I'll sign off. You know, I hope that you all enjoyed this, and hope you all have a great day. Thanks for watching Landedkiller Zombies.